Hello, this is Dr. Arundhati Hoskeri. Let us now discuss about why should we offer bhog or naivedya to God. Actually, hunger and thirst are humanly qualities. God is beyond all this. He is nirakara or formless, and He doesn't require any food or any water or any milk to survive. Then why should we offer bhog or why should we offer naivedya? Well, it is like this. Food is life. Because we eat food, we digest and we assimilate. And this assimilated food becomes part and parcel of our body. Our existence is based on the food. So, food is life itself. So, whatever we eat becomes very, very important. Now, who is God? God is a higher power, the most revered. And so whenever we do offer something to God, we are bound to think whether such a food is worthy of offering or not. Okay, we don't offer stale food or we don't offer any of the food that we feel is not good enough for God, right? So automatically we offer freshly made, well-cooked and nutritious food. And after offering, God is not eating it and going. We are going to consume that food. So automatically, we consume the same food. And unfortunately, today, most of us have no time. Many of us offer bhog to God only on the special days or festivals. But in reality, we don't have to indulge in lot of long rituals or long worships or pujas to offer food on the special days and all that. On day-to-day basis also, whatever you eat, just before you eat, think of Him and offer that to Lord, and that is, that's all is needed over here. So just before you eat, in fact, in Bhagavad Gita, there is a beautiful shloka, which actually we must chant. All our ancestors, they used to chant this as soon as the food was kept, So they would chant this and then eat. That's a very beautiful shloka. It goes like this. Brahmarpanam Brahma Havir Brahmagno Brahmanahutam Brahmena Tena Gantavyam Brahma Karma Samadhina. Now, the purport of this shloka is, whatever I offer itself is Brahma. So, Anna is also called Brahma. Anna means food, not rice. Okay, so Anna also is Brahma. And the vehicle through which I am offering, that is usually it used to be Agni, right? So, that is also Brahma. And to whom I am offering, that also is Brahma. So that it's going to become part and parcel. Actually, if you go to see, Agni is within us also. What is our digestive system? It is like a fuel, like it, it digests everything. So we are offering. So we are first offering it to God, seeing His presence. So the food is worthy of offering. And then we are eating that. And you just do this small prayer and see the vibration it carries and what kind of connection you feel with the Lord. See, whatever we do, a small or big ritual, I don't know. I'm not very, very ritualistic for, make a display of my religion or spirituality. I don't believe in that. Main thing is a connection and how authentically, how honestly you connect with God is more important. Thank you very much. Shubham Bhavatu.